That guy was amazing. Yeah. He played so many instruments. Yeah. Was the crazy thing about Buffet Ben Barfing.
Yeah, he played the harpsichord. Yeah.
He played the skrumpf.
And then he played the hunsnagen.
That one, he's brilliant at
the Yeah, nobody can solo on that like
he can. On the hunsnagen, like Buffet Ben Barfing.
Welcome to another episode of 3 Minute Critics. I'm Eric.
I'm Tony. Today, on 3 Minute Critics, we're going to be reviewing a brand new film on Netflix called Things Heard and Seen.
It is called that.
Is that what it's called?
It is.
Sometimes I get the name wrong.
Yeah, Things Heard and Seen.
Rated TV, ma.
M.A.
This one stars Amanda Seyfried.
Mm-hmm.
I like Amanda.
Mm. Yeah, who doesn't?
It also stars James Norton.
Does.
Rhea Seehorn, Natalia Dyer, and it was directed by Shari Springer and Berman. Shari Springer Berman. And Robert Pulcini.
That's true. That's true.
Please tell the lovely folks out there in what land are they in? YouTube land, something like that. Tell the YouTube land people what this movie is about.
Be happy to. So, Catherine Clare, played by Amanda Seyfried, reluctantly trades in her life in 1980s Manhattan for a remote home in the tiny hamlet of Chosen, New York, after her husband George, played by James Norton, lands a job teaching art history at a small Hudson Valley college.
Mm.
Well, even as she does her best to transform her old dairy farm into a place where her young daughter, Franny, can grow up and be happy, Catherine increasingly finds herself isolated and alone.
Mm.
And soon, she comes to sense a sinister darkness lurking both in the walls of the ramshackle property and in her marriage to George.
Yeah. Sinister.
Yeah, sinister. So
I think we should talk about this.
Let's put 3 sinister minutes on the clock and talk about it.
Give me 3. Give me a big 3.
Tony, your thoughts on Things Heard and Seen.
It was just me, or was this The Shining revisited? I felt like this movie.
Yeah, was it?
Story is very similar. You have a writer. He leaves his normal urban location to go to a suburban place to write, and then he becomes maybe not quite himself as he's dealing with his young family, and there's a child, and then at the very beginning it's filmed with a very Kubrick-esque style.
Okay.
There are a lot of Kubrick slash King tendencies happening in this film. I felt like this film works best when it leans into the horror. I really love the elements that they bring in of the artists, the philosophers, and the music stuff that really ties in the mystical world.
Okay.
And F. Murray Abraham was great in that role as well, but it didn't lean enough into the horror for me, and it starts to lose me as I feel like this film doesn't quite know what it is. You know what I'm saying?
I do, and I don't know why you even mentioned the word horror, because this is not a horror film.
No, and it was almost, at the beginning, you start to feel, there's so much tension being built up at the beginning, and then it just dies out.
You know,
Peters.
I don't even really feel that. I think this was just a pile.
Oh, I didn't find it.
Oh, I know, I really did.
Why?
First of all, you have these two main characters. You have Catherine and George, this married couple, and all of a sudden, like, they move to the you know, to upstate New York,
mm-hmm.
and everything's fine between them, and all of a sudden, for no reason, they're at each other's throats.
Not no reason.
It really comes out of left field.
It's
they
very
do not.
Kubrick. It's very Shining. What happens in The Shining?
When he gets Shining is good. This isn't.
Okay. Yeah. I will agree. But in The Shining, they get to the hotel, and the Overlook starts to become a character, right?
I
and
see
the
that.
Same thing happens in this house.
I see the correlation to it. But there's nothing scary in this house. There really isn't. It looks like there's somebody flipping the light switch on and off. Yeah. And that's what
they miss on that.
They didn't do anything. They didn't make this a horror film at all.
And again, can I just say, what is with the goddamn music?
Nobody can write good music for a movie.
Hire a composer?
Yeah.
I swear to God, whoever is composing film scores these days for every single freaking movie is like somebody's nephew who's sitting at a piano and they watch the movie once and they're like, pling. That's a score.
I feel like Netflix is just kind of like sticking stuff out there right now that's like, we want to see how bad we can make something.
I don't think this was as bad. Can I just say, I don't think this was as bad as you're saying. I think this got close. I think some of the elements that they bring into it are really good. It just doesn't quite get there.
I don't believe any of
any
time.
Think it's as far off as you do.
Catherine's got this eating disorder.
Yeah,
but what's the point of that?
none.
There's none. They do well, so much stuff in here that doesn't
book,
make.
And they try to bring in elements
and
for
they,
the book.
They should have left those things out.
They should have left out, or they should have expounded.
They should
upon.
Have just let it, the horn cut this whole thing off way before the end of the movie.
Let me tell you what the horn means.
What does it mean?
It means it's time to rate this film on a 5-star scale.
Right.
And Glasses McGee is going to give us our first rating.
Glasses McGee. Boy, I...
Boy, I
just don't see a good story in here anywhere. They just... There's nothing given to these actors to do anything with. It's not horror. It's not... There's not a bit of scary in it. There's not a bit.
There's a bit.
No.
There's a bit.
No.
There's a bit.
No, he's lying. There really isn't.
Go ahead.
It's not a horror film. It doesn't really have much of a story to it. It's nothing you haven't seen before. It's just bland, and it drags on and on and on, and the ending is just a unbelievable pile.
I feel like the ending... Well, tell me your rate. What are you rating this?
One.
Oh, no.
One. Oh yeah, no. This was bottom of the barrel.
I was
a little angry at the end of this movie that it stole 2 hours of my life.
I'm gonna say I agree with you about the ending. The ending was a cop out of cop out.
Just
when you build a story like that and you're creating this dynamic, you can't end it that way.
Unbelievable.
And again, Shining. Think about the ending of The Shining and what happens when he walks up to the photo.
Right. They're trying to do, now that you mentioned that, I see
a ripoff of The Shining.
And a terrible one.
So you have the ripoff of Stephen King in the story, and mm-hmm. then you have the ripoff of Kubrick in terms of how it's filmed at the beginning. The axe. There's so many nods
right.
to
Didn't
The Shining.
Think about that.
And basically, F. Murray Abraham is Scatman Crothers. And that's his role.
He's Scatman
in
Crothers.
Film. Now, I didn't hate it as much as Eric, and it would behoove you to check it out and let us know what you think. But I give this film 2.5 stars.
That's
because
generous.
I feel like there was potential there and they really missed it.
And I didn't think like there was any potential. So,
I really liked where it was going.
I mean, this is supposed to be up to you whether you're going to watch this or not.
Yeah.
Because if you want a horror movie, you know, there might
I like
not
me
be...
some Amsai though.
Yeah, yeah, Amsai? Is
I
that
like
what you're
Amsai.
Calling her now?
Oh yeah, we're buds.
Are you like this?
She's right over there.
All right. Hey, what's
Amanda!
Up? Yeah. Whoa. Hey, she can hear
We're
you.
Almost
you don't
done.
Need to. You don't need to yell.
We're almost
no,
done.
We are actually.
Grab me a drink.
We're actually done.
Yeah.
So
no, the other one.
This is the point in time.
Come on.
We would
drink.
Like to thank you so much for watching, and we'd love for you to subscribe and ring the bell
be right
because if you ring the bell, you'll get notified every time we do another one of these strange reviews.
Strange and unusual reviews.
Strange and unusual
by Eric
punishment.
And Tony.
We're out of time.
We're
so
out of time.
We gotta go.
We gotta go.
We gotta go meet
we gotta go
Amsai.
Hang out with Amsai.
Yeah.
She's hanging out over there at the bar.
There's a bar in here?
Oh, it's because there's like 40 people over there.
Oh, we're out then.
They're right there.
We gotta go. We gotta go have a cocktail.
We'll see you guys next time though.
On
The 3 Minutes!
Woohoo!
You got it.